Good afternoon. Can I remind members of the COVID-related measures that are in place and that face coverings should be worn when moving around the chamber and across the Holyrood campus? The first item of business this afternoon is time for reflection, and our time for reflection leader today is Hazel Peters, who is a college student from Greenock.
Thank you for the opportunity to speak today. I owe my nomination to speak because of a letter I wrote to MSP Stuart McMillan about my experiences as a black mixed race person navigating Scottish schools. Speaking about that experience seems an obvious choice, but sometimes I get tired of saying controversial things. I am emotionally weary from recounting my past traumas. Passion for an issue doesn't prevent fatigue of that same issue. I get tired of telling people about the likes of Joseph Knight, a black man enslaved and living in Perth, who in 1778 won a court case against his enslaver, or that way back in 1488, when King James IV ruled Scotland, there were black Moors from North Africa in his court, wanting to improve the school experience for black and people of colour, and ensuring that teaching includes parts of the histories I've just mentioned is something I am deeply committed to. And the opportunity to speak to the Scottish Parliament seems too good to pass up. But it isn't a 17-year-old's job to carry the weight of changing the education system on her shoulders. I would rather talk to you about something I expect to be a shared experience for many of you, youth groups. Previously, I thought youth groups were irrelevant, reserved to church halls and pool tables and tuck shops. Despair of the future of youth groups washed over my head. That was until I joined the youth group Intercultural Youth Scotland, IYS for short. IYS is an Edinburgh-based charity that supports young black and people of colour. IYS was a turning point in my life. I found something that I didn't think existed in Scotland. For the first time, I could spend an evening surrounded by black joy. Young black people dancing to Afrobeats, long braids swinging, dark skin shining, carefree and happy. I understand firsthand how youth groups bring young people together, help us grow in self-belief, and provide opportunities for personal development. I never dreamed that a youth group would lead to opportunities like performing at the Edinburgh Fringe or running a small music festival. I now know what is at stake when people talk about the important place that youth groups have in our communities. In closing, I urge the Scottish Parliament to reflect on the value of youth groups and the investment they make in future young minds.
Thank you. Thank you very much indeed, Hazel.